Hey, oh my gosh, I can't believe that I am here doing a live video. It feels like it's been forever since I have done one of these, and excuse me. I got so much going on right now, it's crazy. I'm in my kitchen and I am cooking dinner. So I just filmed a kitchen spell video and I'm hoping to put that up soon, but I don't know when that's going to be. Anyways, I share a recipe with you that I created. So I'm kind of excited about that. It's been quite a while since I did a kitchen spell blog or video or anything like that. So that'll be fun to get that up. But I was out and about today. It is Manifestation Monday, and I needed to manifest a whole lot of stuff, let me tell you. So the first thing that I needed to do was I needed to go to the bank. And I did that. That was the very first thing that I did. And then from the bank, I had planned on going to my favorite, one of my favorite thrift shops. I needed to get a couple things. Well, mainly I had this goal, and it was to find some vintage cookbooks. And I told myself before going in, that's all I'm going to get. Well, you know what? That never, ever, ever happens, ever. I ended up walking out of there spending like close to $60. But I got a lot of stuff. I really scored, let me tell you. I got a lot of stuff. And one of the things I'm going to talk about today is, sorry, I'm trying to get comfortable in my chair here. Okay, one of the things that, hi. Oh, great. Marionette. Mary, I can't see very well with these glasses. Marionette mask. Okay. Thank you so much for joining me. Yes, we're just getting started. And I'm just going to be talking about some of the things that I did today. And it's Manifestation Monday. So I was just saying that the very first thing that I had to do today was go to the bank. So I did that. Then I went to my favorite, one of my favorite thrift shops, and I spent a lot more money than what I expected. But I filmed a couple of driving vlog videos while I was out and about today. And I was talking about how people that have known me for quite a while know that I like to, that's my microwave. I'm defrosting some food for this evening's dinner that I'm assembling. And I just started talking about that earlier before you joined us that, oh, thanks, May. Okay, sure. And I'm Dina, by the way. My channel is Milady Leela, but if you didn't know, my name is Dina. Anyways, so I'm cooking dinner tonight. It is my husband's birthday, and he's currently napping, but I'm making a really good dinner. And I just filmed also a video of what I'm putting together. And I call those kitchen spells. So I used to film them quite a lot, or at least blog about them. And it's been a little while since I've done that. So that was kind of fun. And I'm hoping to get that video uploaded. It's not exactly like, you know, your average kind of cooking video, but I'm kind of walking you through the recipe and how I'm assembling everything. And so if you have any questions, I always tell people to just go ahead and leave me a message and I can help you out with any questions that you might have. What I'm planning on doing is creating a blog post along with the video where I'll go into a little bit more description on how what the ingredients are and how I'm assembling that. Excuse me one minute. I need to shut off my microwave. So I'm making this wonderful chicken dinner tonight with lots of vegetables, and it's going to be tossed with a pineapple mango salsa on top of egg noodles. So I'm really looking forward to making this dinner. And just give me one more minute. I have to get my noodles off the stove. So everybody can take a look at my background that I have here with all of my stuff that I have hanging on my hanging rack and my clean dishes floating around in the sink. I will be right there. After all, it is close to dinner time, and I'm running a little bit late because Jimmy's napping. So,
All right, so put that down there. And another thing that I'm making that I was talking about in my cooking video is, okay, I'm back. I was talking about the eggplant that I am roasting in the oven. And that is basically, I took an eggplant, I sliced it, and then I just dampened it. And I then dredge it in what I love, this seasoning called Fry Magic. And you can get it at the grocery store. It's kind of like a shake and bake kind of thing. So that's what I use. And you can, what is that? I thought I shut that off. Hang on 1 second. Okay, that was my timer still going off, and I thought I had shut that. Sorry. So you can actually dredge it first in egg if you'd like, but you don't need to. And it's really wonderful, and you just bake it in the oven until it's golden brown, and you might have to check it and turn it over, but it's delicious. And it's just it's a lot healthier than frying it. And also it's a little bit less calories, and if you are vegan, for example, you don't have to dip it in the eggs. So you can do it the way that I'm explaining. Now, I am not vegan. I'm more vegetarian, but there's lots of levels of vegetarianism. And I mainly eat veggies, but I do introduce dairy with eggs and cheese. I don't drink cow's milk anymore. It really affects my system. It doesn't agree with me, but I drink soy milk or almond milk instead. And I do love cheese and I do love eggs. And the meats that I eat are like lean chicken and fish and stuff like that. Turkey, lean turkey. Very rarely, very, very rarely do I even do any kind of beef. It just like doesn't even settle with my stomach. So yeah. So some people might say, well, then you're not a vegetarian. You know what? I hardly ever eat red meat, and the meat that I do eat is the chicken and fish. So I do know that that is a part of being vegetarian. And quite frankly, at some point I would like to even get away from that as well. I'm not doing it right now for a couple different reasons, but eventually that is something that I would like to get away from and do less and less, because I could definitely, hi sweetie, how are you? I could definitely live on veggies. They are just perfect for me, and that's what I love. Okay, so enough of the kitchen spell that I was talking about. There will be a video and a blog on that. I manifested a lot of things today. I went to one of my favorite thrift shops. Then I had to go to the Dollar Tree, and then I had to go to Walmart. Today's video right now, depending on how much time that I have, if I can get all of this haul in one video, I will do that. And then I'll probably change the title, because I think I just put Dollar Tree, yeah, on the title of this video. So I will have to edit that if I'm able to get more time in here and do this entire haul. I got so much stuff at the thrift shop. It was just crazy. I really, really scored and got some really wonderful things. And I started saying that for those of you that have been friendly with me for a really long time, either very personally or here online, you do know that I like to start Christmas shopping or holiday shopping for Christmas and Yule very, very early. I like to get started in July. Christmas in July, yes, that's me. The reason being, I like to be able to get most of everything shopped, wrapped, and out of the way, so that when the holiday season does come around, I have time to really enjoy and spend with my family and my friends. I love to cook. I love to bake. So, and there's so much stress associated with the holidays, starting with Thanksgiving and going into Christmas, more so Christmas because of all the gift shopping and the holiday season that encompasses that idea. And I don't believe in commercialism. It's just really crazy. So, you know, I like to try to get a lot of things out of the way. And one of my favorite things to do is shop at thrift shops and antique stores for gifts. And the reason for that is because I totally believe in recycling. There is so much stuff around the globe, And so many people waste things and just, it's just crazy and terrible. So I really believe in repurposing things, either by using something that for myself that was once worn before or was a treasure for your home before, and revamping it and reintroducing it into my world or my friends and family's world. So I got a lot of things for gifts today and there at the thrift shop. And I also did pick up a few things for myself that I needed, a couple pieces of clothing. And two of them, in fact, I was seriously considering about because they are some sweaters that I don't really need right now because it's summertime and it's very, very hot and humid. I've been considering the whole time I was vlogging that I might just wrap them up and either put from Jimmy or from Santa, or maybe from Jimmy and Santa on a tag, and getting them all prepared for Yule and Christmas and putting them under our tree, because by the time that rolls around, I will have forgotten about that. And so it'll be a nice surprise. And I like to do that too, because I don't need it right now. So, and then that'll save Jimmy, you know, a couple of gifts too. So I always like to think outside the box. But anyways, this video in particular, the title started with the Dollar Tree haul. So let's get into that. I encourage everyone to go grab their favorite cuppa. I'm having iced coffee. It's so yummy. I just have a little bit of cinnamon and some half and half, and I love it that way. I talk about that all the time. It's very refreshing. Okay, so Dollar Tree haul. I got a lot of fun stuff, things I needed too. Okay, one of the things that I got there was this really pretty deviled egg tray. I love this. I was looking at the thrift shop for a glass one, and I couldn't find one today. So I thought, well, Dollar Tree had it, and I love deviled eggs, and I love making them too, and they're the perfect thing to take to a party as well. So I picked this up at our Dollar Tree. And I love that. I also, now I could have sworn that I had some of these before, but I think I gave them to my daughter and my granddaughter to make yummy popsicles for the summer season. So since I don't have mine any longer, I picked up another six pack to create some popsicles. And in particular, I was thinking about making smoothies. And wouldn't that be wonderful to make smoothies and pour them into this? And on a really hot summer day, just taking this out for a nice, lovely dessert and having a little smoothie popsicle. So the thing about this, though, is if you set it in your freezer, and you can't really see right now because if I put it down, you can't, my Chromebook isn't that low. I'm afraid to set this down like this in my freezer because I think it might topple over since we have the slats in our freezer. So I also picked up, this is a three pack of little bins, and I'm going to use one of them to put the popsicle containers in, and then the other two I'll have for my pantry. So I thought that was really great. And I feel like I'm like on the side here. I picked up these birthday candles because today is Jimmy's birthday. These are so pretty. These are silver. So I thought that would be really lovely. We're going to be having caramel turtle brownies for dessert tonight. And this will go on his brownies. I also picked up some Click pens. And these are in assorted ink colors. And I'm probably going to put these away for my daughter because one of the things that I purchased for her, she's going to need some colored inks. So this is going to be one of her Christmas presents. I also picked up, this is new to the Dollar Tree. This is Dove Beauty Cream, and this is just a moisturizer. And I like this because, well, first of all, it's covered, so nobody can stick their fingers in it, which I hate that when people do that in the store. So this is great. I can't really smell it, though, but it smells a little bit rosy to me, which is perfect because I love the scent of rose, and I love roses. Those of you that follow me know that. And this beauty cream is 2.53 fluid ounces, so this is absolutely perfect for traveling.
And I'm hoping to be able to do some traveling to visit my parents around the holiday season. I'm hoping to do that. So if so, it's always great to have little containers of what I need in the right size for the airplane. Also, I picked up, and if you watched my previous Dollar Tree haul, you know that I have been on a mission to find Dollar Tree's coffee that is ground coffee. I love their coffee. It's so inexpensive. It's only a dollar. Obviously, it's at the Dollar Tree. And I love the flavor hazelnut. So I did pick up two hazelnuts. A couple weeks ago, I picked up vanilla. So I've got two hazelnuts. And then I also picked up a breakfast blend. So I am going to probably take one of the vanillas that I picked up. And if you've watched my Antique Emporium haul that I filmed a few weeks ago, I shared with you a beautiful tin that is all about coffee. It has all these vintage coffee pots on it, and it's really adorable. And I couldn't decide if I was going to keep it for myself, for our pantry, or if I was going to gift it. But I think I'm probably going to put the French vanilla inside the coffee tin and gift it to my mother-in-law, probably for Christmas this year. And if she's watching this video, oh my gosh, Mom, I spilled the beans, but she probably is not going to be watching my video. If she does, oh well, she knows what she's getting. So let me just put this all back in the bag because I need to put that away. And I want to keep it all neat and tidy since I'm going to be needing my table. 1 minute. I have just one more bag from the Dollar Tree to share with you. And also, I picked up a bunch of food snacks. One of them I already ate when I went to Walmart. I was starving to death. So as I was shopping in Walmart, I was eating my little snack that I got at the Dollar Tree along with my water while I was browsing and picking up all my groceries. Oh my goodness. Okay. Who else does that? At least it wasn't their stuff. You know, like when you buy something and you open it up because you're so hungry. I've done that too, but oh my gosh, that's terrible to do. And then of course you pay for it at the end, but you know, when you're going through the checkout, but this time I had purchased from the Dollar Tree and had my snack. Okay. This next bag is another bag that I've manifested there with snacks and just a couple surprises. I picked up these sparklers because I am going to be adding these to our dessert tonight for Jimmy's brownies. I can't wait to do that for him. So that's going to be very exciting. I also picked up, oh, the snack that I got was like a nut blend. It had dried blueberries, dried banana chips, cranberries, I think almonds, and cashews. It was so yummy. Okay, so I also picked up some peanuts, and this is fabulous at the Dollar Tree for a dollar, and they're so good. I've purchased these before, so I know that they're good. And then this is mixed nuts. This says bonus size. This does not look like a bonus size, does it? This looks like a bonus size. Anyhow, the mixed nuts are almonds, walnuts, peanuts, and cashews. Oh, yum. That's going to be fabulous. And Jimmy is working all this week, early morning shift, so this will be perfect to make him a little snack mix with some of these things that I picked up. I also have some other things to add to it that I've had at home already. Okay, now this is new. This is I've never heard of this brand before. It says MC Trader. World-class quality. It's the pineapple salsa and it's mild. And you know what? I thought this was a pineapple mango. I don't know why I said pineapple mango. For whatever reason, I thought it was, but that's okay. Pineapple salsa is going to be just fab in our meal tonight for the kitchen spell that I'm creating. So whenever I post my video, I will have to clarify that in the description with the ingredients, that it's not a pineapple mango. It is just a pineapple salsa. So that is going to be added to our dinner tonight. Also, we are going to have for dessert a strawberry and banana
kind of fruit cocktail with a little bit of whipped cream on top as well. So, and then I'm going to put the brownie kind of around it. So I did pick up a fruit cocktail also at the Dollar Tree because I wanted to add some of the things inside the fruit cocktail to our fruit salad. And I picked up a birthday card for my stepdad. And I mentioned before in my last haul from Dollar Tree that they carry the Hallmark brand card. So this is a Hallmark card, which I think is amazing that they carry them there. And it even comes with the stamped Hallmark envelopes. So that is going to be for my stepdad's birthday, which is coming up here in July. And then a few other things from the Dollar Tree I picked up. And these are the Lance brand, so I know that they're really good. These are rich vanilla cream cookies. And again, these are just little snacky things that Jimmy can take to work and snack on. And then I picked him up some peanut butter crackers. And I like these because they're not on that cheese cracker, which is probably not the best health-wise for you. So I got him this instead. It's just like a little regular small Ritz kind of cracker. And then I did get those cheesy crackers that I just said are not that healthy just because I know that he likes them. But instead of getting them filled with the peanut butter, I got them filled with real cheddar cheese. So you have to live life, right? So that's what I got. So that is my Dollar Tree haul. And just going to go ahead and put all of this stuff back so I can make room on my table. Oh, I will make sure I tell Jimmy I'm just reading these comments. Oh, you ladies are so sweet. Well, the coffee is not instant. You have to brew it. It is, the Dollar Tree coffees. It is actually ground coffee. I highly recommend it. I tried it. And you know, here's the thing about the Dollar Tree. It's only a dollar, right? So if it doesn't taste good, it's not like you wasted a lot of money. So I have tried these coffees in the past. I like all the coffees they offer. They offer the breakfast blend, the French vanilla, and the hazelnut. And all three of them are fabulous. Why do I not have... Oh, here, let me show you again. The bag. It is a 6-ounce bag. It says it makes 40 cups. I don't really know. I never really counted to see if it makes 40 cups. But it is really, really good. And also, these make great little gift ideas. Like if you put a basket together and got, like at the Dollar Tree, for example, you could put an entire gift basket together for someone that loves coffee. You could get a coffee. You could get a basket there. You could get a coffee mug. They even sell raw sugar, which I absolutely love. And I have purchased that there before too and shared that in a Dollar Tree haul. I like that so much better. I don't have any here to show you right now, but I did share it in a Dollar Tree haul. The kind that I got last Dollar Tree haul was in the packets because I wanted to include it in some of my Happy Mail packages to let everyone know how sweet they were for being one of my pen pals. But I have also purchased it when it comes in a spout and you just pour it out. So it's fabulous. And I highly recommend the raw sugar more so than white refined sugar. It's better for you. Okay, so let me put this all back. Give me just 1 second, and I want to grab the next bag of goodies because I think I have time. So bear with me because I'm going to be doing some cooking here. All right, I'll be right there. Oh my good, my goodness. When I say I'm hauling it, you are not kidding. I am hauling it. I got so much stuff to show you. Oh, goodness gracious. Okay. All right. All right, so now we're going to get into the thrift shop haul. And I went to the Goodwill store today. Let me just adjust this. I feel like, there we go. I should have done that from the very beginning. I'm so sorry. And my bra strap falls down. Okay. I'm going to have to go ahead and change the title because I'm letting Jimmy sleep as long as he needs to sleep. He probably will sleep until I call him down for dinner. So if that is the case, then I have all this time to get this done with all of you before he comes down. And if you don't mind, I'm just going to get up a couple of times to start doing some of the cooking that I need to do as I am sitting here in my kitchen. I've got my noodles are done. The vegetables are cooking down. And then the next step is I need to grill my chicken. You know what? Before I get into this bag, though, let me just double check my oven and make sure that my eggplant is doing okay. So I'll be right back. And it's looking really good. Okay. It's nice and crispy. Oh my goodness. It's strap. Okay. So now I can sit down with you all. Get organized here and share with you all of this goodness. Okay. So I'm going to pull my shirt up here because it's going to fall off my shoulder anyways, which I like it like that, but I don't want it to completely come off as I bend down. So craziness, I tell you. Okay. So the first thing I'm going to get into, thank you. The first thing I'm going to get into is some candles. I love searching for candles at the thrift shops. They usually have the most fabulous candles, and sometimes you can find them and they have never even been burned. And that, of course, is the best kind to buy. I don't really like to buy other people's burned candles because you never know what they use them for, and just like that's weird. So I don't do that. But if it's brand new, it's mine if it still looks good and if it's in good shape. So I picked up a couple of candles for the holiday season. I am so excited about the holidays rolling around. I cannot tell you. Before we know it, Yule is going to be here and then Christmas. I am so excited. So I found this lovely green candle for $1.99. Look at this beautiful pillar candle. Now, my Chromebook is showing all of this stuff that I'm sharing with you a little bit darker than its true color. This is really a pine green in color. It's so beautiful. Look, the wick is perfect. And I love how it's fluted all over. And it was only $1.99. Yay! I cannot believe that. That's fabulous. Okay. The next candles that I picked up were two for 99 cents. Unbelievable. These were marked at $2.49 a piece at one point in time. But I know these candles, I've seen them in certain brands. In certain brands, they're even more expensive than $2.49. I think I've seen these for like maybe $5 at different places. But these are two beautiful Christmas red taper candles. And they're the ones that are really fat at the top and then they have the thinner bottom. So they sit in a nice, let me see if I can grab one and show you. Reach over here. Right now, currently, I have my beeswax candle in here with a, not a cloche, oh my goodness. I cannot think of what these are called. Do you ladies remember what these are called? The little catch-all for the wax? There's a specific name, and I think it's French. And I can't think of it right now. I know. Me too. Believe me, I have a candle problem. If I'm not buying candles, I'm making candles. I made these beeswax candles, by the way. And I do have votives that I've made. These are really difficult to make. I made these at my friend's house because she has the pillar thing that you can dip into your wax burner. But I don't own one of those. So I do mine by hand and it takes way too long to make them for purchase. But I do make the votives for purchase. And I also, I don't think I have anything here to share. But I also make melts, beeswax melts in heart shape for purchase. And I also make heart shape tea lights. So those are really cute. But anyhow, the cool thing about this is I'm going to take this off for a moment just so I can share with you how this goes. So this goes just like that, and it just looks so lovely. Of course, you take your plastic off. You know, you're not going to leave plastic. Oh, my goodness. I crack myself up sometimes. I'm, like, so weird. I'm such a nerd. All right, so I'm putting my candlestick back. Watch my face. Oh, my God, right in front of you. I had no idea. All right. Okay, so that was my candles. And let me move those out of the way so that I can make room for more stuff. I'm surrounded by stuff. Okay, so the main reason I think I started saying this in this video is that, Babetch, that's it, Mary. That is it. Or May, I'm sorry. Your name is May. I apologize. That is it. It's a Babetch. Yes. That's exactly what it's called. So I started saying I went originally to this thrift shop with a mission to only purchase and look for vintage cookbooks. Well, that didn't happen, obviously. I got candles and a whole slew of other things that I ended up walking out of there with. Oh my gosh, I spent like $60. But like I said, you get a lot of stuff at the thrift shop for that kind of money. And I figure it's better to spend it now than around the holidays, because when you start shopping around the holidays, it's like you end up spending so much more money because everything is so commercialized. So I got a lot of really cool stuff that I'm going to give as gifts. So I got these really pretty placemats. There was four of these. I probably should have bought all four of them. But I only bought two because my mother-in-law has a table for six. And I could have got the four. But I figured if I get two, then she could put one at the head of the table, on each end of the table. Look how pretty this is. Is that not gorgeous? Oh my gosh. That is so gorgeous. And she loves placemats. I use placemats too for a lot of different things, but I don't use them at my table. I use placemats, and one of these days when I do an up-close kitchen tour, which I've done kitchen tours before, but not up close, I line my wood furniture with placemats, and I have leopard in my kitchen and zebra. Yeah. I also line my cupboards. One day I'm hoping to do an organizational tour of my kitchen and show you how I've lined my cupboards with my zebra and leopard placemats. And they look so cute. I've even lined my refrigerator with zebra placemats. It looks adorable. And then it, in the kitchen, refrigerator is perfect because then if something spills, all you have to do is wipe that placemat and it doesn't like drip and get all over everything. It's like fabulous. It's a great organizational idea. So I encourage you to think about that. Okay. And this is funny because we have a record player, but it's not in use right now. It's downstairs in our basement. It's been in storage forever. I don't even know if it works anymore because it might be like the humidity and just like damage, you know, from being in the basement for so many years. It might not even work. So I'm kind of whispering this because I don't want my husband to wake up and hear this. I think I'm going to put these away for Christmas and also put these under the tree, another thing from Santa, because one of the things I'm hoping to do is, regardless if we could get our record player playing, I want to get one of those record players that are like in a suitcase. Have you seen those? They are so cool. In a suitcase, or the kind that looks like an old-fashioned, it's kind of like a radio. It has, well, it's really not old-fashioned because it's got a, like a CD player in it and a radio. and it plays records. I don't even think way back when they had them in suitcases. I don't know. But depending on the cost and where I can find them and how much room I have for what I'm thinking of, I want to buy a record player. Jimmy and I have a nice collection of records from like years ago, before CDs were even made. Oh my goodness. That is kind of like giving my age away. But these are so cool. And we both love Glenn Miller, like the old-fashioned orchestra stuff. So I got this for us. I love this. And I love the vintage look of the album. And the album itself looks really awesome, too. And it, inside, it seemed to be in pretty good shape. And I have a friend here on YouTube. His channel is called Oddbox Topper, and he does a lot of videos. If you are a vinyl lover, he does a lot of videos where he talks about all the records that he has collected and how to clean them and this and that. So I will go ahead and try to remember to link his channel in this. The next one that I got, oh my gosh, this is amazing. This came with a business card on top of it. From Utah in Salt Lake City. And speaking of Christmas, oh my gosh, this like melts my heart. It's so hard to try to read to while I'm talking, May. Let me see. Oh yeah. Oh, that's awesome. Oh my gosh. Well, okay. Jimmy and I both love the Mormon Tabernacle Choir. They are amazing. I found this Christmas album from the Mormon Tabernacle Choir singing Christmas carols. Oh my goodness. My heart, I cannot wait to listen to this. And there's a business card on it from a president of the Bonneville International Corporation. He's the president from Salt Lake City, Utah Social Hall. So like, how cool is that? Oh my goodness. All right. So I'm going to wrap those up, and those are going to either be, well, there's probably going to be from me and Santa to me and Jimmy. So, oh my gosh. Didn't I tell you I love shopping for Christmas? I love shopping for gifts for people. And I know my sweet Radha, I know that's just your YouTube channel name, but I love calling you that here on YouTube. But I know that you always say, oh, you're so sweet, Dina. You're always thinking of other people and giving gifts. I love gift giving. I love it. I love holiday time. I love birthdays. I love to give people gifts. I just love it. It just makes me feel so good. Anyhow, okay, I did purchase a few other things for myself today, but I still have a few things to show you about gift-giving times. This was fabulous, and I love this because this looks really vintage to me. This is oven-safe paper bakeware, and it has snowflakes on it. It's in green. You would think it would be in blue, but it has snowflakes, and it has bells and, snowflakes and bells. And I thought this was perfect. These are little liners so that you can do some bread baking. And I have a fabulous recipe for friendship bread. And my son and I did an entire, I don't even know what you want to call it, but season, shall I say, of friendship bread. And boy, it once you get started, it goes around forever. And it's so yummy, but it's so like rich and so high calorie, but it makes the perfect gift giving time for breads to make. So I might, it's like a sourdough bread basically. But you fill it with all sorts of sugary, wonderful things and flavors. So, I'm probably going to get into that again. And I can't wait to share that with my son and tell him that I got these baking, things because we can do this together, and that might be a fun thing to do for the holidays. So I'm excited about that. Oh my goodness. And they look so vintage. You know what I love about Christmas time too is at Walmart, if you have a Walmart in your area, if you're from the States, I'm sure everyone does. At Walmart, they put all of these really cool paper baking tins out. Paper trays. And they're so cute and colorful. I love them. And that is like the best gift. Like somebody could gift me paper baking trays and I would be happy. I would be in my glory because I love to bake. I love cupcakes and cakes and pies and all those things. So, this was a great find. Okay. Speaking of baking, I do believe that this is for baking. This is one of those ovenware kind of plastic, safe for the oven trays. This was, oh, and by the way, those placemats were only 99 cents, and this was $1.99. This was $2.99. And I'm not going to be using this for baking. This would be perfect for like little tiny bite-sized brownies or maybe even petite fours, which are like little cakes. I have another way to make petite fours, and it's just you basically bake your cake and then you know, like a one layer cake, and then you cut it into squares. So they're not exactly perfect. They're a little bit more organic, and I love it that way. But this, my friends, I purchased this because I also make soaps. I make bath and body potions for my Milady Leela shop. And if anybody is interested, you can always purchase from me here on YouTube as well by letting me know that you want something that you see or that you hear about. And I can email you and give you information, pictures, et cetera, et cetera. But around holiday time, I love making soaps, specifically guest soaps, because everyone entertains around the holidays and they always need beautiful little herbal type soaps. And I thought this would be the perfect size for guest soaps. I have used candy dishes before to melt my soaps into and mold them. But after a while, they kind of get yucky and you have to throw the molds away, but this will always be something that will stay good forever. So if you take good care of it. So I thought that would be perfect. And I can't wait to get into that. My guest soaps are so lovely. I will be presenting more of those into my shop, probably on Etsy as well. Come closer to the holiday season. Ooh. One more moment. I have to get up and check my dinner. I'll be right back. It is looking good, everyone. Looking good. Okay, so I'm trying to make room for everything. Let me just reach. Oh, sorry about that. Right under my arm. Oh my gosh. You're getting like all this like TMI, right? Oh my, I'm so sorry. All right, there's a few other things in this bag I want to share. Okay, so I can't decide on this one if I'm going to keep this for myself or if I'm going to gift it to my daughter for the holiday. I'm probably going to gift it to one of my daughters, but I'm not sure. This is a little cosmetic bag. Look how super cute this is. It's really glitzy and glammy. It's like kind of like, I don't know. It's sort of like a silvery gold, if that makes sense. It's like a rose gold is really what it is. It's so beautiful. And I'm thinking that my daughter, my youngest daughter, would probably love this most. And this was only $1.99. And I have some beautiful jewelry pieces that I'm giving to her as well for the holidays. And so I think that would look beautiful inside this little pouch. And I know the reason I'm mentioning her is because I know that she doesn't watch my videos. She absolutely does not have time. And I had mentioned earlier in my driving vlogs about this other gift that I'm going to share with you in a moment. For a special lady that I got this particular item for that I'm thinking of right now, which I'll share just a moment, as I said. And I wasn't going to mention who it was for because I was concerned that she might watch my videos. And I know she just might. She just might. So I'm not going to say who that's for. But let me tell you, that was the deal of the day. And I'm getting to that very soon. Okay. So remember earlier in this video, I said that my mission today was to get vintage cookbooks. And I got so much more. Oh my. Okay. So this I thought was really cool. I'm not exactly sure what this is. I think. Okay. So it looks like a placemat, right? And it's got strings here and strings on the bottom. It has a pocket here, a pocket here, and pockets down here as well. On the back, there's Velcro on either side. So what I'm thinking about is I think this probably goes like this. And maybe it's to keep something warm. I don't know. It doesn't make sense to me. But here's what I thought. I could use this attached to a picnic basket, which I thought would be super cute, make it look really, really vintagey, and hang it onto a picnic basket and then like stuff utensils and the different things that we need in the pockets. The other idea I had for this is the strings are just a little bit too short to tie around my waist, but if I attached for the specific idea another ribbon on either end, I could make a little apron. Here I am covering my face. Whoop, sorry. Whoop. I could make a little apron to wear when I do my craft shows. My trunk shows, I usually have a cash box with me. Funny story, today to go thrifting, I wanted to go into my cash box that I use for my shows because I always keep a little bit of extra in there to use if I'm going out to breakfast with a friend or, you know, if I want to grab something for a thrift shop excursion. That's just kind of like my little cash thing that I use to save some of my stuff, some of my extra money that I save for these special occasions when I go out shopping. And I was looking for it and I couldn't find it. Why? Because I reorganized my studio and I remember taking it out of the drawer that I had it in and going in my head, I'm going to put this here and I'll remember where it is. Well, guess what? I forgot where it is. So I don't know where it is. So anyways, but I thought that's okay because honestly, the cash box is not necessarily my friend when I do a craft show. I have found that I like to stand in front of my table and work my way around the table when I talk to passersby and people that are purchasing from me. I like to give them my time and I don't like leaving my cash box on my little table where I do my business to wrap. Because while I'm busy with a customer, somebody could come up around and get into my cash box. I know that sounds terrible to say that, but people are like that. So I am not really a fan of that. And I thought this would be perfect to make it like an apron and tie it around my waist. And then I would have pockets in the front to put things in that I needed. And then the pockets in the back that were against my body could be the cash and things like that. So that is what I really thought I would use this for. And then, of course, when it's not in use for my trunk shows, I could use it for picnics because I love going on romantic picnics with my husband. So I thought that would be really cute. Okay, this was awesome. Oh my gosh, you guys, wait till you see this. This find was fabulous. This was a fashion find and it was brand new. Listed for $7, $6.99, so $7. Totally rad. These beautiful, let me show you like this. This is how they go. These beautiful boots. Look at these. Oh my gosh. They're tall boots. They're slouched with this little buckle on the side and a wrap around the buckle goes around the ankle. They're about a 2.5, close to 3-inch heel. The only damage, if you want to call it damage, is this little spot right here, but I will touch that up with a brown marker and fix that. So totally worth it. These were never worn, I can tell by looking at them, and they are gorgeous. You can't see in this lighting, so I apologize, but these are a beautiful bourbon brown color. I cannot wait to wear these. I know, aren't they? I can't wait to wear them, May. They are so beautiful. I love the buckle. It's like a brass color buckle. Oh my gosh. It's going to look so good
with some of my outfits for the season. I just can't wait to wear them. So I had to buy those. And I did splurge on myself by getting those. It was only $7, so it's really not a splurge, but I did have to get them for myself. Okay, so I did talk to you about vintage cookbooks. I got a few new ones, but I did find, I think, one or two vintage ones. And one in particular, it melts my heart because I'm going to tell you a story in just a moment. I need to check my veggies. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. This story is really special to me. Many, many years ago, when I was a child, my mom had a vintage cookbook that had a picture of a birthday cake that was done in the shape of a boat. And my mom made this cake one year for my brother's birthday. And I always loved it. And in fact, I think I had my mom make a copy of that picture. And I do believe from the book, and I do believe that I have it somewhere amongst my cookbooks. And I'm in the process of redoing my kitchen a little bit, reorganizing some stuff in some of my cabinets. And I'm hoping to come across that because that would be very cool. But I found the book that my mom had when I was a child. And I wish it was my mom's book, but I had called my mom a week and a half ago and asked her if she had any of those books left because she had the coolest, like Better Homes and Gardens and things like that, vintage cookbooks. And I'm so into like vintage stuff. I'm so, everybody that knows me knows that. And those of you that follow me here in my social networks, you know that too, that I love all things vintage. And Victorian kind of things and stuff. So anyways, she said that she had gotten rid of all of those books. And I felt so sad because they had such good memories associated with them. But I found the exact book today. So I'm going to share that with you right now. And I can't wait to call my mom and tell her. It is the Better Homes and Gardens Holiday Cookbook and Special Occasions Cookbook. And this is it. I love all the vintage pictures in here. It's so amazing. Like, look at this. It's so cool. I love the photography from back then. It was very, it wasn't quite as sharp as the photography is today. When you see pictures and photos and books of recipes and even just in general, it just had this like really old world kind of look. But back then in the 70s, you know, that was the thing. Like that was what we went with. So look at this, just like salads and stuff like that. Let me show you this picture of this birthday cake. It's just so fabulous. See if I can find it. Okay, so anniversary buffet. Oh my gosh, look at this. Look at this. So cool. And I think one of the girls who I follow here on YouTube, Sweet Emmeline, I think she shared one of these recipes, but I'm not sure. It looks very similar, the cake. All right, here's the cake. It's the boat right there. I love it so, so much. And then this one too, right here, a carousel. I think she made that one year too. And I made the carousel cake for my children when they were little, but I revamped the recipe and kind of changed things up. So I am so happy that I found this book. I cannot wait to tell my mom about it. And let's see when the copyright was. Oh my goodness. 1959. Oh my gosh. I love it even more so. So this book was circulating for a very long time because my mom had it in the 1970s when I was in grade school. Oh my goodness. This is fabulous. New Year's Eve, February days, sunny Easter breakfast. Oh my gosh. Oh my. Love, love, love it. Okay, I don't want to put that there because it's resting on. Let me just move this just a little bit. Okay. open. Make sure the sound is up. Hang on. Okay. And then a few more books. This is another vintage book, I do believe. Let me see when this was copyrighted. I'm a book collector too. I love books. Oh my gosh, I have so many books. In fact, I have to sell some of my books. I have that many. That's how bad it is. Candles and books, May. this was 1996. So no, this isn't really that vintage, but it's still an older book and I love it. The stuff from the 90s was pretty cool also. This is Classic Vegetarian. And as I said, I am really excited about vegetarian meals. So this is perfect. I can't wait to dive into this book. I don't have anything like this. And the pictures in here are really exquisite. Look at this. This looks amazing. This is spinach and ricotta stuffed shells. Looks so good. Oh, God. Okay, so very excited about that book. And a couple more books. This is another one. This is Everyday Celebrations. This is a newer book. This says Savoring Food, Family, and Life at Home. And I had to get this because my heart, I am like a true homesteader. I don't have a homestead. Like, I would love to be able to grow my own food and have animals and things like that on my property. I don't really have room for that because I'm really, I live in the city. So, but I do have a little yard and I do have a garden and I do harvest a lot of my own flowers and herbs and things on a smaller scale. So I'm a homesteader in a way. I'm like a farm girl at heart. So Mary Jane Butters has this whole thing about, being a farm girl, no matter where you live. And so that's me. I'm really a city girl, but, my heart is on the farm. So if that makes sense, but this is like perfect because, this has all kinds of ideas, wonderful, wonderful recipes and ideas about taking care of your family and your friends. And it's just really just ideas for arrangements for your tables. Look at this idea here of this beautiful conch shell with flowers coming out of it. That is amazing. So, you know, just things to make your tablescape beautiful and magical. And I am all about that. So I love that. And so I did get those three books for myself. I got this book for my grandson. This is a book that I remember reading to my kids at the library when they were little. And now I have a grandson who is a little boy, and he's very little. He's only three. Is he three? I think he's three. Yeah, he's three. Oh my gosh, I lose track of time. But anyways, this is Eric Carl, The Very Busy Spider. This is one of my favorite children's books. And I'm really happy to be able to have the opportunity to gift this to him. The artwork in here is gorgeous. Look at that. Those are supposed to be trees and they're just gorgeous in color. And let me show you some of the pictures. Just amazing. Now there is some coloring in here from a little child who has loved this book before, but that's okay. That is okay. We'll go with that. And I love how the pages, so for example, here's some of the artwork. And I love how the pages are. This is very unique. I don't recall this from whenever I read this story to my kids, but the pages are doubled and there's like a pocket in between, but it's open at the top and bottom. So I think that's really cool. And I can't wait to give that to my little guy. Cannot wait. All right. So that's that. Let me check my food. I'll be right back with you. This is quite a long video. We're into an hour already. So those of you that are still hanging out with me, your diehards, thank you for being here. I hope you grabbed your favorite cuppa and have a snack too. All right. I'm going to wash my hands, and I'm going to go ahead and add our chicken to this dish. So I will be right back with you. Go ahead and grab a snack or your favorite cuppa while I'm doing this. Let me tell you, these veggies look absolutely wonderful. Okay. All right, so I am back. Thanks for waiting. Oh, I'm so happy you do, my sweet Radha. I am so happy you do, because I love doing them too, and it just seems like the past few Mondays have been so crazy that I was doing Manifestation Monday videos, like, pre-recorded and then uploading them. But this is like great to be able to be back here live. Okay, so now the next stuff to share with you is all inside this beautiful bag. Check this out. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? This is a big quilted bag, and this was one of the treasure finds I found at the thrift shop. Also, I purchased this with a couple of ideas in mind. This was only $4.99, so I could not pass it up. It reminded me of kind of like a Vera Bradley, but not really, because it's not really quilted, although it feels quilted. So it's kind of Vera Bradley-ish, but the pattern on it, and the lighting is so terrible in here. I apologize that you cannot see the beauty of this. It is done in beautiful burgundies and purples and greens of vintage florals. It's so gorgeous. Oh my God. I love it. So I got it because originally the first idea for it was that I would use it to store things underneath my bed and keep dust and things like that off of it and just keep it inside this bag. And then, of course, be able to use the bag for travel if ever needed. But I also thought when I was in my car, because the lady at the store put most of the items that I purchased inside here, I thought, oh my goodness, I could use this bag because it folds up so nice in with, I hate using plastic bags, because they're so pain in the butt to carry, first of all. I don't like the fact that they clog up our environment, and I want to try to do something with them, like knit a rug or something. Has anybody ever seen those? They're so cool. You take them and you cut them into strips and you knit with them, and you could make like indoor, outdoor kind of rugs. They're so super cool. Or you can crochet with them, whatever. I haven't gotten to that yet, but... That can happen. But in the meantime, I hate how all those plastic bags like ruin our earth and clog it up. You probably hear my chicken cooking in the background, by the way. It's sounding and smelling yummy. Okay, so I thought that I like to carry when I can my own canvas or cloth grocery bags. But sometimes even that, carrying all of that in is a lot. So wouldn't it be wonderful to bring them in something like this, and then I could just carry everything all together. So that is an idea that I thought of. Anyways, I love it, needless to say. So I talked a little bit earlier about
getting some sweaters for myself that I'm going to wrap and put under the tree from Jimmy and Santa. So those are in here, and I'll be showing you those in a moment. And I got a lot of really awesome treasures. So let's start with this. Okay. Goodness gracious. Okay. This is wonderful. This was only 99 cents. I could not pass this up. I think it was 99. Well, it was marked 99 cents, but there is a ticket on it, I think, that came from, I don't know. She might have charged me $1.99. But you know what? I don't even care because it was worth it to me. This is beautiful. This is a headband, and it's vintage. It's like a millinery flowers here. You know, isn't this gorgeous? It's millinery flowers and a beautiful feather in burgundy. I love it so much. I cannot wait to wear this. I thought that was super cool. I'm going to have to check my receipt because I'm just curious to see if she charged me $1.99 or if she charged me a dollar for that. This was $1.99. This is a beautiful vintage-like Christmas stamp of this gorgeous white reindeer and two little children with stocking hats on. I thought this would be adorable to stamp at holiday time on envelopes to decorate. I have to check my chicken. I'll be right back. It's looking good. Okay, this is the eggplant that I was telling you about. And I left it in the oven kind of long, but that's okay because I wanted them to crisp up like chips. And these would be great dipped into like a salsa. So I'm going to try that because I'm going to be using, let me try that right now, actually. I'll be right there. Oh, well, I can't get the jar open right now, so never mind. But these are pretty good. They'd be better dipped into something, and I was hoping to get that salsa open, but I don't want to take up too much time doing that. Okay. Mm-hmm. Where was I? All right. Jimmy will not like those chips. He doesn't like eggplant. All right. Ah, look at this. Okay. This is for candles, really. There you go, May. For candles. This was $1.99. Looks like somebody hung it as a wreath somewhere. But what I bought it for was because I love these flowers. They look really vintage and I'm probably going to be able to use them in some upcoming projects. So I love that. Then for 99 cents, they had two crochet hooks. So I have my own crochet hooks, but I'm thinking about getting my granddaughter started, and learning how to crochet, because crochet is a lot easier to start with than knitting. She has a little bit of trouble knitting. So she's 8. And she could knit, not a problem, I'm sure. But it's a lot easier to just start with chains. And they're fun. And then she can chain and make chains for her Christmas tree at the house and all that stuff. So I got her very own. And I have lots of skeins of yarn, so I can gift her some really nice colors and things like that for holidays in maybe a basket, maybe even this basket. This was $1.99. And it's, take this out a minute. It's a really good basket. It's a Country Woven Collection grand basket from Massbeth, New York. But it does say made in China. So there you go. I don't know. But look how cool this is. So maybe I'll start her like a little knitting basket or crochet basket, right? How cute is that? And for the holidays, she loves crafting. And then this I thought was adorable. This probably was filled with perfume at one time. It reminds me of something that Avon might have sold. But I thought it was so cute, super cute. And originally I thought of my granddaughter for this. I thought maybe I'd make her something and put it in here. I don't know. I might even keep it for us for the holidays because it looks so vintage and it's really adorable. And I do collect bottles. So I might just keep it for us for decoration for the holiday. What do y'all think? Should I keep it for us or should I give it to my granddaughter? You know, if I gave it to my granddaughter filled with perfume, the bottle is glass and my grandson is only 3. So I don't know. You know, it might be better if I kept it. So I'll have to think about that one. Okay, let's see. More stuff. I got this tin. I thought this was really beautiful. This was a candy tin at one time. And I shared with you before, if you watch my journal workshop videos and you participate with me live, I have a tin that Jimmy had gifted me with caps on it. And that was filled with Whitman's candies. Well, this is also Whitman's. And it was filled at one time with candies. I collect tins. I love this. What I loved about this particular one, though, is that I love this girl on the front. She reminded me of a goddess, and she kind of reminded me of Bridget. I just thought she was beautiful. So I had to get it. And this was 99 cents. Okay, remember I told you that I really scored at the thrift shop in getting something that was really, really beautiful. Keep it and give to her when she gets older. She will remember it from your house. And it, oh, Rada, I love that idea. Yes, crochet is good when you want to relax. Yep. Yeah, I'm going to keep it for us because I have a bottle collection. You probably can't see because I have vegetables that I just brought in from our garden hanging out over there. I have my dish drain, which all the dishes are clean. And on the other side where you can see my wooden bowl, I have to put them away. But I do have above the shelf, you might be able to see some of them. I have a beautiful little bottle collection. So that, my friends, is going to look beautiful on that windowsill at holiday time. But getting back to the fabulous fashion find, score deal of the day, I cannot believe it. I found, oh my gosh, this is amazing. Are you ready? Wait for it. I found a Prada handbag for $4.99. Yes, $4.99. I've mentioned in my vlog video that is that I did when I was driving, I don't really do yeah. I know. So true. Yeah. Okay. What was I going to say? Oh, I forgot now. Anyways, let me get back to this handbag. When I got up to the register with this handbag, I had made a comment that it was the deal of the day. And then I couldn't believe it was only $4.99. And the girl, the clerk there said, they must have overlooked that, because usually those kind of designer bags, oh, I know what I was saying, and I'll go there in a second, that those kind of designer bags, they usually mark up a little bit. And I've seen that happen. They're usually like $14.99 or $12.99, which is still a really good deal for like a designer handbag. What I was going to say is, I don't really treat myself to things like that. Now, at the thrift shop, yeah, I probably would if it was my style. This particular bag is adorable, and it's floral, and it looks like it might be my style. But, you know, handbags are like journals. They have to speak to you. They have to really speak to you and say, I am the one you need to take me home. I am yours. This particular one did not really do that. You know, it's like this thing, this bag. It really spoke to me. It's not a handbag, but it really spoke to me. So bags are like that. But my daughter, and I wasn't going to mention her name. I'm not going to say which one. But my one daughter, well, actually, they both like to collect handbags. But my one daughter in particular, she would never, ever get anything like this for herself, ever. So I'm going to put it away for her. And I know she's probably not watching this video. My granddaughter might be, though. So if you're watching this video, shh, don't tell mommy. Look at this bag. The girl said that she probably, it was probably missed, and but she had to sell it to me for what the price tag was on it. And like I said, it was $4.99. Yay me. Look at this bag. Is this not adorable? This looks like it might be my style. And it's cute. I would probably wear something like this, but it's not really calling to me. And I just feel that my daughter would appreciate it so much more. And it's Prada. So, like, she just has to have it. It's just so beautiful. The inside was in perfect condition as well. Absolutely perfect condition. Just amazing. I cannot wait to give this to her. Oh my gosh. Just, I'm going to fill it with all sorts of lovely things that I've been keeping for treasures for her for the holiday season anyways. And she'll open this up and then see all these other treasures inside. It's just going to be a great, great experience. So I can't wait to do that for her. All right. And just a few more things. My granddaughter made cheerleading. So I found this little frame. It was only $1.99. And it's in perfect condition. And I'm just going to paint it the colors of her school. And then she can place her cheerleading photograph inside. So I thought that was really adorable. And I'll probably give that to them as a family gift. Then for one of my very special friends who loves nature and she loves leaves and she lives out in the country, this was handmade. So I thought this was really, really beautiful. Really beautiful. It's signed by the artist. It was only $1.99. And I can't wait to give this to her. I will probably fill it with some of those gorgeous Bath and Body Potion soaps I told you about. And then she can have this on display in her home. Whether or not she wants to use it as a soap dish will be up to her. But there you have that. And then lastly, the clothing items that I told you about that I'm going to wrap up and put away for the holidays. This is a cute little sweater. I love this. This was 50% off today. It was listed at $4.99. So let's say $5. I got it for $2.50. And it's a crop sweater with really long sleeves, extra long sleeves. And it just looks so adorable on. So, so cute. I love it so much. And then one more sweater. And this one is kind of like a putty color or a cement color. It's really cool, like a gray. And it's just like a, oh, I forget what this pattern is called. I can't think today. But I just love all the detail. Like it has this beautiful detail on the bottom. And really pretty pattern, and it ties at the waist. So you can either tie it in the back and leave the tie down, or you can
tie it around your waist. Really cute, and I think it'll go with a lot of different things. So that, my friends, is my haul for today from the Dollar Tree and also from the thrift shop. I did get some things at Walmart as well, but they were mainly groceries and just a few other little things that I needed. And so I'm not really going to get into that because that's not very exciting. But thank you so much for being here with me on Manifestation Monday, July 2nd, 2018. I was so happy to be able to bring this live video to you. I haven't been able to do one in a couple of weeks, and it felt really good to do this. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do. I'd really appreciate that. Oh, okay, sweetie. Love you too, Radha. Aw. I hope you enjoy the rest of the video. Sweet dreams. And May, thank you so much for your comments and for watching as well. For those of you that might pick up this video later after it's been recorded, I hope that you subscribe to my channel. I would love that. So, yes, and I have a few more videos coming out about today's day. So stay tuned for that. And if you hit the little bell, you'll be notified to know that I have posted something. Once again, I just want to mention, I appreciate all of you so much for supporting me here on my YouTube channel. My little channel is growing so much by all of you that that take the time to hang out with me and watch my videos, whether they be live or pre-recorded. And that means so much to me, and it really helps me do what I do. It gives me the information basically to know that I'm making a difference, and that feels really good. If you'd like to leave a tip and donate to my channel, any contribution is greatly and completely appreciated. You do not need to do that though. There's no obligation at all, but every little bit helps, and it continues me. It helps me, excuse me, to continue on my mission of spreading love and light around the globe and talking about art and sharing art and inspiration and how to assemble different things and put things together and do hauls for you to inspire your soul and all of that good stuff. So I love you all so much. Oh, I am so happy to hear that, May. Thank you. You don't know how much you inspire me and brighten my day by watching and commenting. Thank you. So with that being said to everyone, have a beautiful rest of your evening. I wish you much love, many blessings, and many friendships to come. And I'll see you in my next video. Oh, see you in my next video.